Whitney, you all set?
Yes.
Okay.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
So I've been doing my injections now for, I guess, almost a week. Mm-hmm. And I'm actually feeling pretty crappy. I'm like just really, really tired and nauseous. I almost threw up just like getting here in the car.
That's quite normal.
Okay.
And it can actually mean that your estrogen levels are rising.
Okay.
We actually got your estrogen levels.
Is it good?
It's good.
Oh, good.
And we'll see what the ultrasound shows.
Okay, I was afraid I messed it up. My dad was like, "You're telling me that a doctor just lets you inject these needles?" And I said, "Yeah, Dad, this is what I'm telling you." He was like, "Oh." I was like, "I'm not putting in a vein." He was not very optimistic about my ability to give myself medicine, which what does that say about he thinks I'm going to be a mom?
This is my first ultrasound since I've started the fertility medications, and I'm really nervous because I've been like mixing up all these vials and injections and doing it all myself and not really sure if I'm doing it right. And this process is very expensive. So if I've messed it up and we don't have any eggs growing, it's going to be a problem.
So this is your uterus.
Uh-huh.
This here is your wonderfully responsive right ovary, and this is telling me that the medications are working.
Yay!
See, these follicles are bigger
than
you've ever seen them before.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there's multiple, and they're growing evenly, and this is all good things we want to see.
Oh, I'm so proud of myself for doing it right.
Your ovaries are very responsive.
Look at them, good job.
Yeah.
To be quite honest, I'm shocked because I feel like my body never really does what like people expect it to do. And certainly in the realm of my fertility, like, oh, what is it doing? So I feel relieved. And of course, I'm glad it's working because it has actually been pretty rough on my body and definitely rough on my psyche, so.
Now, is this the leftover? What are we?
This is still the right side.
Because I was going to say, remember how you said it was real hard to get to or whatever?
Yeah.
Because I'm hoping maybe we can actually take from both.
Oh, yeah.
Is it my position? Can I move?
You can try coughing. Okay. See, that brings it down a little bit.
Doesn't it? How funny.
With the pressure in the abdomen. I'm a little nervous about being able to reach her left ovary since it's higher. I'm hoping that with some pressure and coughing, we can reach that ovary without some aggressive maneuvers. It's still too early to predict exactly what day your procedure is going to fall,
okay.
But...
So we're in like, so this is, so it's like basically a week
estimate,
away.
Rough estimate, yes.
Do women hug you a lot? Like, I'm so excited. I don't even have anything retrieved yet, and I'm already so, so excited.
Honestly, this appointment could not have gone any better, knowing that I can have eggs frozen and then therefore everything can be delayed a little bit. Really gives me a lot of comfort. And obviously I still have to like have the actual procedure, but I'm feeling really optimistic. Hey, Daddy.
Hey.
Hey. I just wanted to give you a quick update. I just got another ultrasound. He said everything looks really good. And he thinks that they're gonna be able to retrieve my eggs in like a week. So that's exciting, because this is really expensive, so I hope it works, you know?
I'm still mystified how they will give you
I told him
stuff to mix up.
I told him that.
And inject yourself with all
that
stuff.
I told him. But yeah, so I'm doing it. Oh! Well, I gotta go chase down a paper. I've just lost my uterus schedule. Gotta go, Dad. Love you.
All right.
Bye. Bye.
Physiologic and training considerations for individuals who are obese. Zero chance of passing that thing.
I can't imagine what it's like to actually be pregnant because honestly, just these fertility drugs are knocking me on my ass. I have run to the bathroom more times than I can count today. The good news is that they gave me some anti-nausea medication. The bad news is that it ain't really started working yet.
Hello.
Hello.
What's wrong with you?
You're lucky you're not here. I just threw up.
Oh, why? What's wrong?
These hormones or the injections or whatever. Look at my bags. You see my face? Have you ever seen my face look this bad?
I don't know if this is what being pregnant feels like.
I mean, I wouldn't say this bad, but you do look rough for you.
I'm just like so nauseous, so exhausted.
Well, Lord, God bless it.
I know, but my follicles are really big and juicy.
Go follicles, go follicles. You're like, I don't mean to brag, my follicles look really good.
My follicles are huge.
Whitney, you really don't look too good. I remember the morning sickness when I was pregnant, and there is a reason that I stopped it too. I'm getting nauseated just thinking about it.
Got bad news.
What?
Me and the French man had a kerfuffle.
About what?
He had gone online and was like looking at Chase's social media.
Oh God.
And he saw that post of all the horrible things people said to Chase, and he was like, that really scared me and all this. And I'm like, yeah, I get it.
I was surprised when he brought up Chase's social media. I didn't realize that that's something he would like think to go back and look at necessarily. And it does suck because I've been dealing with this kind of like vile from the internet for the last 8 years. So in a way, like I'm kind of numb. As much as I don't want it to possibly ruin a future relationship, more than that, I mean, he deserves to have it not ruin his life.
I mean, if I'm not gonna meet the French man, then I just feel like I should just hang it up, really. Because I mean, oh, stop! I've been through it.
I know, and trust me, I say the same things about myself. We both know that that's not realistic. Yeah. Neither one of us needs to give up. We're 37, we got time.
Do we?
We do.
I can understand where Whitney's coming from. It's definitely frustrating. And I can understand where the French man's coming from. This is not a life for everyone. But I think it's a little bit too early for Whitney to be freaking out about it now. I think we need to just ride it out a little bit, see what happens, see if his mind changes. We don't know anything at this point.
All right. Well, oh my God, I'm sorry.
Oh God, oh God.
Oh, I'm sorry.
All right,
I'm gonna go back to bed. Love you.
Love you.
Bye-bye.
Lucky girl, you're so beautiful. Look, smile. Good job, Winnie.
Is that a kitty?
Look at this baby.
I cannot believe it.
Wanda,
unrestrained.
It has been a roller coaster of a week with everything going on with the Frenchman and the IVF stuff. So I really just want to like pause and refocus.
Has anything?
Oh, hold on, I gotta inject. You do it for me.
Ooh, I don't know if I trust myself to do that.
Yeah, you can. Well, I don't want to put Wanda down.
I've never injected anyone with anything.
Let's go.
This is not within the realm of my responsibilities.
I'm trying to take it a little bit easy because my nausea is still coming and going, definitely more coming than it's going. And I have to mix up all these medications morning and night and inject them into my stomach. I just hope that it's worth it in the end because I don't want to go through this process again and I definitely don't want this egg retrieval to fail.
Whitney, my hand is shaking.
And just pull it out?
That felt so crazy.
I didn't feel a thing.
Oh my God.
I'm gonna need a bonus for injecting her with medication. I mean, I can make a mean spreadsheet, but I'm no field medic.